that. He can report, as seen it by his wife, the newest state of the remote.
This the sergeant who, like a good and hardy soldier, hath fought against my captivity. Hell, great friend, say to the king the knowledge of the world as thou didst leave it.
Doubtful it stood. The merciless MacDonald, worthy to be a rebel, for such do the villainies of nature do multiply upon him. But brave Macbeth, well, he deserves that name. Disdaining fortune with brandished steel, with smoke, with bloody execution, till he had sinked him from his name to his chaps and fixed his head upon our battlements.
Oh, valiant cousin, worthy gentleman.
But I am faint. My gash is crying for help.
So well thy words become me as thy wounds. They smack of our abode. Go fetch him, surgeons. Who comes here?
Worthy Thane of Ross.
God save the king.
Whence camest thou, worthy Thane?
From fire, great king. That most disloyal traitor, the Thane of Cawdor, began a dismal conflict. Point against point rebellious, arm against arm, curbing his lavish spirit. And to conclude, the victory fell on us.
Great happiness! No more that Thane of Cawdor shall deceive our bosom interest. Go pronounce his present death, and with his former title, free Macbeth.
I'll see it done.
What he hath lost, noble Macbeth hath won.
Oh, why upon this blasted heat you snuff our way with such prophetic greeting? and stain.
Were such things here as we do speak about? Or have we eaten on the insane loot that takes the reason prisoner?
Your children shall be kings.
And you shall be king.
And Thane of Cawdor too,
was it not so?
To the self-same tune and words. Who's here?
The king hath happily received, Macbeth, the news of thy success. And when he reads my personal venture in the rebel's mind, his wonders and his praises do contend, which should be thine or his. As thick as hail came most with most, and everyone did bear thy praises in his kingdom's great defense, and bore them down in front of him.
We are sent from our royal master to give you thanks,
and for an earnest of greater honor, he made me from him call thee Thane of Cawdor. In addition which, hail, most worthy Thane, for it is thine.
What? Can the devil speak true?
The Thane of Cawdor lives. Why do you dress me in borrowed robes?
Who was the Thane? Lives yet. But on a heavy judgment bears that life which he deserves to lose. Treason's capital, confessed and proved, have overthrown him.
Longs, the Thane of Cawdor, the greatest is behind. Thanks for your haste. Do you not hope your children will be kings, when those who gave the Thane of Cawdor to me promised no less to them?
That trusted home might yet enkindle you unto the crown besides the Thane of Cawdor. But 'tis strange, and oftentimes to win us to our harm, the instruments of darkness tell us truths, win us with honest trifles, to betray us in deepest consequence. Cousins, a word I pray.
Two truths are told as happy prologues to the swelling act of the imperial theme. I thank you, gentlemen. This supernatural soliciting cannot be ill. Cannot be good. If ill, why hath it given me earnest of success, commencing in a truth? I am Thane of Cawdor. If good, why do I yield to that suggestion whose horrid image doth unfix my hair and make my seated heart to knock against my ribs against the use of nature? Present fears are less than horrible imaginings. My thought, whose murder yet is but fantastical, shakes so my single state of man that function is smothered in surmise and nothing is but what is not.
Look how our partner's wrapped.
Chance will have me king, why? Chance may crown me without my stirrup.
New honors come upon him, like our strange garments cleave not to their mold, but with the aid of use.
Come what come may, time and the hour runs through the roughest day.
Worthy Macbeth, oh, we stay upon your leisure.
Kind gentlemen, let us towards the king. Let us think upon what hath chanced then in more time, the interim having waited. Let us speak our remarks to each other.
Very glad.
Until then, enough. Come, friends.
Is execution done, Count Cawdor? Are not those in commission yet returning?
My liege, they have not yet come back. But I spoke with one that saw him die, did report that very frankly. He confessed his treasons, implored your highness's pardon, and set forth with a deep repentance. Nothing in his life became him like the leaving it. He died with one that he studied in his death. To throw away the deerskin yeomaness, 'twere a careless trifle.
He was a gentleman on whom I placed an absolute trust. A worthiest cousin, the sin of my ingratitude even now was heavy on me. Thou art so far before that swiftest wing of recompense is slow to overtake thee. Only I have that to say, more is thy due than more that all can pay.
Well, the service and the loyalty I owe, in doing it pays itself.
Welcome hither. I have begun to plant thee, and will labor to make thee full of growth. Noble Banquo, thou hast no less deserved, and must be known no less to have done so. Let me enfold thee, and hold thee to my heart.
If there I grow, the harvest is your own.
Sons, kinsmen, thanes, and you whose places are the dearest, know that we will establish our estate upon our eldest, Malcolm, who we name hereafter the Prince of Cumberland. But Jacques must not unaccompany the investiture only, but signs of nobleness like stars will shine on all deserters. From hence to Inverness, and bind us friendly to you both.
I'll be myself the harbinger, and make it joyful the hearing of my wife if I approach. So humbly take my leave.
My worthy Cardinal.
Prince of Cumberland, that is a step on which I must fall down, or else or leap, or in my way it lies. Stars, hide your fires. Let not light see my black and deep desires. The eye wink at the hand, yet let that be which the eye fears when it is done to see.
The less after you, whose care has gone before, to bid us welcome. Back!
Come. unsex me here, and fill me from the crown to the toe top full of dyer's hoof. Make thick my blood, stop up the axis and the passage to remorse that no compunctious visitings of nature shake my fell purpose. No keep peace between the effect and it. Come to my woman's breast and take my milk for all. You murdering ministers, wherever in your sight the substance is, you wait on nature's mischief.
If it were done when 'tis done, little well were done quickly. If the assassination could treble up the consequence and cast with his Circe's success, that but this blow might be the be-all and the end-all here. Here upon this banked shoal of time, we would jump the life to come. In these cases, we still have judgment here. He's here in double trust, First, as I am his kinsman and his subject, strong both against the deed. Then, as his host, who should, against his murderer, shut the door, not bear the knife myself. Besides, this Duncan hath borne his faculties so meek, hath been so clear in his great office, that his virtues would plead like angels, trumpet-tongued, against the deep damnation of his taking off. Pity, like a naked newborn babe, shall blow the horrid deed in every eye. The tears should drown the wind. I have no spur to prick the sides of my intent, but only vaulting ambition, which o'erleaps itself and falls on the other. How now, what news?
He has almost supped. Why did you left the chamber?
Oh, have he asked for me?
No, but he has.
We will proceed no further in this business. He hath honored me of late, and I have bought golden opinions from all sorts of people, which will be worn now in their newest gloss, not cast aside so soon.
Was the hope drunk wherein you dressed yourself? Have it slept since? And wakes it now to look so green and pale on what it did so free. This time, such, I count thy love. Art thou afeard to be the same in thy own act and valor as thou art in desire? Wouldst thou have that which thou esteemest the ornament of life? Live a coward in thy own esteem, letting I dare not break upon my bosom.
Pretty peace. I dare to walk and become a man. Who dares do more is none.
What beast was it then that made you break this enterprise to me? You durst do it. Then you were a man. And to be more than what you were, much more the man. I have given suck, and know how tender it is to love the babe that milks me. I would, while there was smiling in my face, have plucked my nipple from his boneless gums and dashed the brains out of my sword as you have done with it.
If we should fail.
How comes the night, boy?
The moon is down. I've not heard the clock.
find a 12.
I take this light, sir.
There is husbandry in heaven. Their candles are all out.
Who's there?
A friend. What, sir? Not yet at rest. The king's a bed.
Good repose a while.
Thanks, sir. The light to you.
This is a dagger which I see before me. The handles warm my hand. Come, let me clutch thee. I have thee not. And yet I see thee still. Art thou not fatal vision, sensible to feeling as to sight? Art thou but a dagger of the mind? A false creation proceeding from the heat-oppressed brain? See thee yet forms palpable as this which I now draw. Thou marshalest me the way that I was going, and such an instrument I was to use.
Thine eyes are made fools of the other senses, or else worth all the rest.
I see thee still, and on thy blade in dungeon gouts of blood which was not so before.
There's no such thing.
It is the bloody business which informs thus to mine eyes. Now over the one half world nature seems dead. Wicked dreams abuse the curtain's sleep. Thou sure and firm set earth, hear not my steps which way they walk. For fear thy very stones prate of my whereabouts, and take the present horror from the time which thou suits with it. Once I threat, he lives. Words to the heat of deeds too cold breath gives. I go and it is done. Bell invites me. Hear it not, Duncan, for it is a knell that summons thee to heaven or to hell.
What hath made them drunk hath made me bold. What hath given them quench them has given me fire.
Nature's second course, cheap nourisher in life's feast.
What do you mean?
Kill it, cried! Sleep no more! To all the house! Moms hath granted sleep, and therefore Cawdor shall sleep no more. Macbeth shall sleep no more.
Who was it that thus cried? Wife, worthy thane, you do unbend your noble strength to think so brave seekly of me. Go, get some water, wash this filthy witness from your hands. Why did you bring the daggers from the place? They must lie there. Go, carry them and smear the sticky groats with blood.
I am afraid to think what I have done. Look on it again, I dare not.
Firm of purpose! Give me the daggers. Sneaking in the dead are but his pictures. Tis the eye of a child with the ears of a painted devil. If he do bleed, I will skill the faces of the grooms with it, for it must see their guilt.
Whence is that knocking? How is it with me when every noise appalls me? What hands are here? Pluck out mine eyes. What? Will all great Neptune's ocean wash this blood clean from my hand?
Lou. Lucifer, pleased to meet you. Oh, yes.
Come! No!
What business is it that such a hideous trumpet calls to parley the sleepers of this house? Speak, speak.
Gentle ladies, is not for you to hear what I can speak. Repetition in a woman's ear would murder as it fell. Banquo, Banquo, our royal master's murdered.
Woe, alas, but in our house.
Too cruel anywhere. Dear, doth pretty contradict thyself and say it is not so.
Had I but died an hour before this chance, I had lived a blessed time.
What is amiss?
You are and do not know it.
Your royal father's murdered.
By who? Those of his chamber, as it seemed, has done it. Their hands and faces were all bags of blood. So their daggers, which unwiped, be found upon their pillows.
Oh, yes, I do repent me of my fury that I did kill them.
Wherefore did you so?
Here they told him. His silver skin laced with his golden blood. And his gash stabs look like a breach in nature for ruin's wasteful entrance. They're the murderers, steeped in the colors of their trade. Their daggers are unmannerly breached with gore. Who can refrain that had a heart to love, and in that heart courage to make his love known?
Help me hence.
Look to the lady.
Fears and scruples shake us. In the great hand of God I stand, and thence against the undivulged pretense I fight of treasonous malice.
And so do I.
So on! Let us briefly put on manly readiness. We meet in the hall together.
What will you do? Let's not consort with them. The showman of God's sorrow is an office the false man does easy. I'll take the lid.
To Ireland now. Our separated fortunes will keep us both safer. There's daggers in its smiles here. The nearer blood, the nearer blood.
This murderous shaft that shot hath not yet lighted, and our safest way is still worth the aim. Therefore, of course, let us not be bent here, leave taking but shift away. There's warrant in that man which steals itself when there's no mercy left.
How goes the world now,
sir? Why, see you not?
Is it known who did this more than bloody deed?
Those that Macbeth had slain.
Oh, that's the day. What good could they pretend?
It was drawn. Malcolm and Donovan, the king's two sons, are stolen away and fled, which puts upon them suspicion of the deed.
Against nature, indeed. The frivolous ambition that was ravaged up by no life's means. Then 'tis most likely the sovereignty will fall upon Macbeth.
He's already been named. Come soon, be invested.
Will you just do?
If he had been forgot, it would have been as a captain on a great feast with all things under.
knight hold a solemn supper, sir. Now request your presence.
Let your highness command upon me, to the which my duties are with a most indissoluble tie forever knit.
Ride you this afternoon.
Aye, my good lord.
We should have else desire your good advice.
Fail not our feast.
And my lord,
I will not.
We hear our bloody cousins are bestowed in England and in Ireland, not confessing their cruel parricide. Adieu to your turn tonight. Go, play out with you.
I am the lord.
Farewell. Let every man be master of his time till 7 at night. To make society this meet a welcome, we'll keep ourselves till supper time alone. Well then, God be with you. Attend those men our pleasure.
There are, my lord, without the king.
Bring them before us. To be thus is nothing. To be safely thus. Our fears and Banquo stick deep. And in his loyalty of nature reigns that which would be feared. 'Tis much he dares. And to that dauntless temper of his mind, he hath a wisdom that doth guide his valor to active safety. There is none but he whose being I do fear. He chid the sisters when first they put the name of king upon me, and bade them speak to him. Then, prophet-like, they hailed him father to a line of kings, no son of mine succeeding. If it be so, for Banquo's issue have I filed my mind. For them, the gracious Duncan have I murdered to make them kings. Banquo kings. Who's there? Now, go to the door and stay there till we call. Both of you know Banquo was your enemy?
It is true, my lord.
So he is mine.
He shall, my lord, perform as you command.
So while I, your spirits shine through you. It must be done tonight. And something from the palace. And leave no grubs or botches in the work. Cleons, his son, keeps him company, whose absence is no less material to me than is his father's, must embrace the fate of that dark hour. Resolve yourselves apart, I'll come to you anon.
We are resolved, my lord.
I'll be with you straight by the king. It is concluded. Banquo, thy soul's flight did find heaven. Spine down to act.
Has Banquo gone from court? I, madam, have returned again tonight. Say to the king, I will attend his leisure for a few words.
Madam, I will.
Lost hand. All spent. For our desire was wrought without content. It is safer to be that we destroy than by destruction dwell in doubtful joy. How now, my lord? Why do you keep alone? Of sorriest fancies your companions making, using those thoughts which should have indeed died with them, they think on. Things without all remedy should be without regard. What's done is done.
You have scotched the snake, not killed it. Duncan's in his grave, after life's been
knee sleeps well.
Yeah!